Glucagonoma is a rare type of neuroendocrine tumor that originates in the pancreas and produces an excessive amount of the hormone glucagon. This can cause a variety of symptoms, including weight loss, skin rashes, and diabetes, and is typically diagnosed in middle-aged or older adults. Treatment may involve surgical removal of the tumor and medications to regulate glucagon levels and manage symptoms. In this video, we will introduce the glucagonoma definition, causes, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, and prognosis. By the way, welcome to our channel. Don't forget to thumb up and subscribe. What are the symptoms of glucagonoma? The symptoms of glucagonoma can vary, but common signs and symptoms include weight loss, skin rash, hyperglycemia and diabetes, anemia, diarrhea, abdominal pain, weakness and fatigue, mental confusion or depression. It's important to note that these symptoms can be caused by a variety of conditions, and a definitive diagnosis of glucagonoma can only be made through medical evaluation and testing. Glucagonoma causes. The exact cause of glucagonoma is unknown. However, it is believed to be related to a genetic mutation that leads to uncontrolled cell growth and the formation of a tumor. Other factors that may contribute to the development of glucagonoma include long-standing high blood sugar, obesity, and other underlying health conditions such as diabetes. In some cases, glucagonoma may also be associated with a condition called multiple endocrine neoplasia type 1, which is a genetic disorder that affects the endocrine glands. However, this is rare and only accounts for a small percentage of cases. It is important to note that having one or more of these risk factors does not guarantee the development of glucagonoma, and many people with these factors will never develop the condition. Further research is needed to fully understand the causes of glucagonoma. How is glucagonoma diagnosed? Diagnosis of glucagonoma typically involves a combination of medical evaluation, laboratory tests, and imaging studies. The process may include physical examination. Your doctor may perform a physical exam to check for signs of skin rash and abdominal pain. Blood tests. High levels of glucagon in the blood can indicate a glucagonoma. Your doctor may also check your blood sugar levels and conduct other tests to look for anemia, high levels of liver enzymes, and other signs of the disease. Imaging tests. Imaging tests such as CT scans, MRI scans, and PET scans can help your doctor locate the tumor and assess its size and location. Biopsy. In some cases, a biopsy of the suspected tumor may be necessary to confirm the diagnosis. The biopsy involves removing a small sample of tissue for examination under a microscope. If a glucagonoma is suspected, your doctor may also refer you to a specialist, such as a gastroenterologist or an endocrinologist, for further evaluation and management. What are the complications of a glucagonoma? Glucagonomas can cause a variety of complications, including hyperglycemia and diabetes. Excessive levels of glucagon can lead to high blood sugar levels, which can result in diabetes and other related complications. Anemia. The disease can also cause anemia, which is a condition characterized by a decrease in the number of red blood cells. Blood clots. People with glucagonomas have an increased risk of developing blood clots, which can lead to serious complications, such as deep vein thrombosis and pulmonary embolism. Malnutrition. Weight loss and diarrhea can lead to malnutrition, which can weaken the body and make it more susceptible to other health problems. Neuropsychiatric symptoms. Some people with glucagonomas may experience confusion, depression, or other neuropsychiatric symptoms as a result of the disease. It's important to work closely with your healthcare provider to manage these complications and maintain optimal health. Early detection and treatment can help reduce the risk of serious complications and improve quality of life. Which department treats glucagonoma? Glucagonoma is a rare type of neuroendocrine tumor that typically requires a multidisciplinary approach to treatment. The following departments may be involved in the treatment of glucagonoma. Endocrinology. An endocrinologist is a doctor who specializes in the treatment of hormone-related disorders, including glucagonoma. they can provide guidance on the management of hyperglycemia, high blood sugar, and other hormone-related symptoms associated with glucagonoma. Surgery. Surgical removal of the tumor is often the first line of treatment for glucagonoma. A surgeon with experience in treating neuroendocrine tumors is typically involved in the surgical management of the condition. Medical oncology. In cases where the tumor has spread to other parts of the body or cannot be completely removed through surgery, medical oncologists may be involved in the management of glucagonoma. They can provide guidance on medications, radiation therapy, and other treatments that can help manage the disease. Radiation therapy. In some cases, radiation therapy may be used in conjunction with surgery or as a standalone treatment to shrink the tumor and relieve symptoms. A radiation oncologist is a specialist in treating cancer with radiation therapy. Dermatology. Some patients with glucagonoma develop a skin rash called necrolytic migratory erythema, which can be treated by a dermatologist. It is important to work closely with your doctor to determine the best treatment plan for your individual case. Treatment options of glucagonoma. Treatment for glucagonoma typically involves a combination of surgical and medical approaches, and the specific treatment plan may vary depending on the size and location of the tumor, as well as the overall health of the patient. Common treatments include surgery. The primary treatment for glucagonoma is the surgical removal of the tumor. This may involve a partial pancreatectomy, removal of part of the pancreas, or a total pancreatectomy. Medical management. After surgery, medication may be necessary to regulate glucagon levels and manage symptoms such as high blood sugar and anemia. Radiation therapy. In some cases, radiation therapy may be used to shrink the tumor or relieve symptoms such as abdominal pain. Chemotherapy. Chemotherapy may be used in combination with surgery or radiation therapy to shrink the tumor and reduce the risk of recurrence. Supportive care. People with glucagonomas may also benefit from supportive care, such as nutritional support to maintain optimal health and address symptoms such as weight loss and diarrhea. It's important to work closely with your healthcare team to determine the best course of treatment and to manage any complications that may arise. Early detection and treatment can help improve outcomes and reduce the risk of serious health problems. Prognosis of glucagonoma. The prognosis for glucagonoma depends on several factors, including the size and location of the tumor, the patient's overall health, and the presence of any metastasis. In general, early diagnosis and treatment can improve the prognosis for patients with glucagonoma. In cases where the tumor is small and has not spread to other parts of the body, surgical removal of the tumor may result in a complete cure. However, in cases where the tumor has spread or is located in an area that makes surgical removal difficult, the prognosis may be more guarded and long-term management may be required. It is important to note that every case of glucagonoma is unique and the prognosis can vary greatly from person to person. A specialist in treating neuroendocrine tumors should be consulted for a more specific prognosis. Thanks for watching, take care and stay safe.